For doing that, you have to randomly come up with keyword names. It doesn't have to be like some name which, I mean, you have to. It's not that. It is something you can put in Amazon and see like if there is something you can find. I mean, if I just say hand, leg, head, anything, road, travel, this and that, anything you can put on Amazon and you will see random products there, right? So from the random products, you can take ideas like what are the products are there, then go on researching, take the keyword of from the title. Okay, let me do that. If I say, I mean, just that, just like that, I'm saying, okay. Okay, so if this is, I mean, if I come over here, I'll say hand. I mean, just like that, I say hand. So you see a lot of things, right? I just put hand, nothing else. I'll put hand, eye, head, mind, whatever, pain, whatever you think of. Like, I mean, you can just randomly put and see. You need to get some keyword. So hand doesn't show me anything. So when I say hand, maybe it will show something. Can I hand towels, hand fan, hand mirror, this and all, hand mirror. Who knows what could be. So this is something it comes. Hand mirror not be good one. Mirror is something will not. It's breakable kind of product. So it's not good to go for that kind of breakable product. So this is one way, like one way you can randomly put some word, random word, and try to search over here, right? And then get the maybe I'll say salon barber soap is one. And from this itself, you get the keywords, right? So let's say silicon handle. I'll say silicon handle. Or handle, I'll say something, handle only. So you just keep on expanding. Handle something. So you see there are a lot of other things which is coming up. Like this is something new type of product you saw. And from this you get the keyword. It says RV extension, something like that. Here it is, hardware company. Some handle. It's showing more of like handle only. Yeah, this handles. But is it something I can get some other ideas from it? This small. This is basically one broad keyword, one single word, which I had put and tried. I was trying to see if I can get some other words, right? See here, handle holder, hot handle holder. Silicon hot handle holder. This could be one. It's a best selling, but it's not a costly product. It is just 4.99. So probably will not I mean go for the product cost, which is something like that. But you got some idea here. It says that silicon handle. Maybe I can copy that silicon handle. Okay, I can put that silicon handle so I'll get some more ideas. Click on handle. Yeah, so you got some more ideas. These all handles it comes now. This is price wise, it's not good. So I would not. Here it is something 7.88. So you can see this one. Okay, this is set of, I think, pot cover and all. Yeah, silicon hot handle pot holder with silicon pad. So it is combined together, 7 point something is there. So this probably could be the one which you can think of, like mat silicon pad is the other one, right? You derived another word, silicon pad. See what is there. Like, I mean, this is more of like coming, this ladies, these things. That also is a potential product. This also silicon hot holder, pot holder. Is the one, right? So silicon pot holder is another keyword which you got now from here. So you started from hand, handle, then silicon handle, then silicon pad, silicon pot holder. So now you're going on a different, I mean, trying to find keywords, right? So right. this is how you have to get keyword ideas. I know, like, you might be thinking that thinking probably would be difficult. If you just keep on thinking that, oh, this, that, then you may not get idea. But you have from somewhere you have to get idea. So Amazon is the best place where you can get idea, right? So you keep on trying different words. Start with one broad word, then go on the list. See if you can find from the title other words, right? So
yes, sir.
Here you got some silicon pot holder. So this could be one product for you itself. Like, you can say silicon pot holder, right? But you have to be careful in terms of the pricing. So if that is something, then you come over to this one, your Amazon. Take that keyword and put over here and just do that. Before Amazon also, you can quickly check if there is a trend. I mean, putting Amazon will take some time. Instead, you can come over to Google Trend, right? Trends. Silicon pot holder, just put that. Not sure if you'll get something. You got something, yes. There is a trend shown, but a trend is not that much good trend what is being showing up. But if I go from 2004, it's not that great trend for the silicon hot pot pad, right? So it's not great trend. Then you can try to get something else from here. If heat resistant is the one, you got some other word, just try finger protector or oven mitt, right? Take this words from here. Oven mitt is one. Let's say oven mitt. What is that oven mitt? Okay. Oven mitts. Yeah, so you got something else now. Oven mitts. This is something called oven mitts, right? So you got something else. So now you put that word like oven mitt here. What happened? It's pretty much like seasonal product. It gets sold more numbers in December month. So we would not be looking for something which is seasonal. You see that seasonal, right? It is more such during the December period. So during the Christmas period. So that yes, means sir. That during that time, people gets into cooking stuff and all, right? So that's why it is. But from here, again, you take something else, right? You take baking, grilling, because placeholder. So barbecue pot holder. It's barbecue is coming. Kitchen set. Oven globes. What is the one? Oven globes would be the same. Oven meat and oven globes. So from there, like, if I go back to the last page, there was something. Multi-purpose kitchen tool. Kitchen tool would be heat resistance. Let's be put heat resistant. I don't know. Heat resistance will be heat resistant gloves, heat resistant tape, heat resistant mat, heat resistant BBQ glow. Okay. So heat resistant gloves. I think that would be something similar to
seasonal.
Yeah, it will be more of like seasonal only. Looks okay, but not that great trend wise. It's not that great actually. No, it's not that great consistent type of like it's not consistently going up. It's more of like up and down. You may not think of, I would not say just think of. So you go on trying something different now from hair styling. Just put hair styling. I don't know if you get something. Right? Hair styling. You got something else now, right? Hairstyle. From hand to hair you went. Hair styler. Hairstyling, something we'll put. I don't know what we'll get. Hairstyle. Okay.
Okay.
So you get here print style collection here. This is for kids. This new breeding handbook, modern twist, classic hairstyle. No. So hairstyle, like if, when you see this products, don't look for the product which is used for hair cream or hair. These are products we are not thinking of, cream and all, right? We are not.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Yeah, so we'll not go for that kind of product at the beginning. Later point, once you are confident, then you can think of going for restricted product and all, but not for the first product. First product, don't think of going for any restricted product.
Okay.
You can, like, if you think, I mean, it is up to you. If you are brave enough, that saying that in the sense, like, you can work for all the approval, and you can go through the product research, what all the documents are required, what are the certifications required. If you are thinking that you can do that, then go for that. That's definitely a good choice in terms of the competition, because that is the kind of product which for which many product doesn't go on. Sorry, many sellers don't go on that path. They will not go on to restricted product. But if you say that, no, I'll go for the restricted product just because I'll be out of competition, right?
Right.
So that could be, another way how you can bring down your competition numbers. Yeah, so here you see headband Vandana, right? Headband Vandana something. Headband Vandana, maybe you can take this one. Japanese style something. You copy this headband. So which is... maybe you can just put headband, not that much required. Let's Bandana, we are not focused on any specific type thing. So we are just exploring the keywords from the ideas here. So headband, you got so many headbands. Okay. So this is how you keep on trying. Like I cannot go on the whole thing. Like you got the idea, right? So I say hand, hair, whatever, hand, hair. Leg, palm, whatever, leg pillow. See, leg pillow, you got something else. Leg pillow. Yeah. Okay. You got idea from here. Leg pillow. But
okay.
It looks very competitive. But you can like get some more hip pain relief. Pain relief is the one. So if I say pain relief. Pen, I'll just say pen. Paint brush, pen. It's all paint, it has become. So I'll say pen. I've given a space, then I get that. Pain relief patch. So these all would be pain relief, cream relief. These all will not cream and patch. It'll just all these things will not go for. So pain relief would be little, restricted again. So we may not go for that, but this here, nerve pain relief, knee pain relief, this is a orthopedic leg pillow, right? This is a leg pillow which is used as orthopedic leg pillow. So if somebody's leg is fractured or anything happened, as such, this kind of pillow are used to keep their leg on rest, right?
Yes, sir.
So this is definitely a good product which you can explore. I'm not saying this could be a potential one. You can definitely explore. Pricing is little definitely okay. It's good pricing. 23.5 selling price is good. And if you find, this product in good buying price, yes, it will be definitely a good product. Only thing is that you have to see how is your competition. If the competition is really high, then no, will not. Right? Let's see this here. If this is one thing which you have to see here, this number. Okay. When you see this number are very, less, then you probably think that competition is less. Okay.
Okay.
So that's what you have to look on. Whenever you put on any keyword here, try to search, and you see the number here. If the number is less, then competition is less. If competition is less, then it is good. The only thing is that you have to see if the selling numbers are good on the first page or not, right? And the competitors, like selling numbers, how do you see? You have a tool called Jungle Scout. I don't know, like, if you will be having that. You do not have Jungle Scout, right? Do you have Jungle Scout, Chandra? No, you do not have. I have not suggested to buy. This is a paid tool, in fact, Jungle Scout. But you can go for a free tool. I was telling you that just go to Google. Just say Market Intelligence from Viral Launch. Intelligence from Viral Launch. Yeah. So this is the tool which you should. Or there is one more called Unicorn Smasher. With free tools you can go for Unicorn Smasher. Like Jungle Scout only. AMZ Scout, Unicorn Smasher, try free. Go for this. New Chrome extension. Where is Unicorn Smasher? They've changed something. You can go either of the one, or you can, try both of them. That's not a Unicorn Smasher. Yeah, here it is, the Chrome extension. Go for this Unicorn Smasher Chrome extension. Okay.
And is it free, sir?
Yeah, it is free. It is free. You can install this Unicorn Smasher or Market Intelligence is the another one. Chrome extension here, Viral Launch Market Intelligence. This also you can install. Okay. So when you install, it shows more of like Jungle Scout only. You can say add to. Okay, I'll just install it because I have Jungle Scout paid version, so I do not use. You can use any this and that. Unicorn Smasher and. Okay, so it is checking. I'll add this. It's taking time. It'll get hanged, probably. Okay. It's installed now. Viral Launch. This is also installed. All of them are not required. Now I'll just remove it off. But you can go for like two. That's okay too. You can just compare. The result of.
Okay.
Unicorn Smasher and the Market Intelligence and see how it is, like how the data are showing up, if there is any difference and all. But mostly, like, you will find the similar data from both of them, similar thing. Okay, so when I come to this link below, I can run this Viral Launch Market Intelligence or Unicorn Smasher. That, let's say I'm just running this Unicorn Smasher instead of Jungle Scout. the same kind of information will be shown up.
Okay.
So before I go on to Amazon, I think I have to close this. This got installed or something. You can like do this. You can see if, quickly see that if the sales numbers are good on the first page, right? And the competition are low. This number should be low, really low. If it is less than 1,000 or 500 to 1,000, that's good. You can, I mean, if and the sales are good and the review numbers are less, okay? The okay. first five numbers, the review what you are seeing, if it is below 50, then that's excellent. Below 50, okay? Okay. 50. Okay, I'm just showing up Jungle Scout. I think somehow it is not starting. Okay, so here you see that you're seeing that this one, this has good review numbers. The competition is definitely huge. But if you see this here, just 20 reviews and making really good, revenue. See, 9,000 they're making just for 20 reviews. That's really yes. not bad, really good. They're making good. But the challenge is like competition looks tough here because the top sellers are selling. I mean, their reviews are really high. So you have to probably think, not to go for this. Or maybe you can do little analysis and see if this market can be a good market, or if you can deviate little bit from this and to some other market. Okay, so here so somehow I feel like it's competitive because it has high number of reviews. Most of the competitors has high number of reviews, so that way it is competitive definitely. Okay, so now let's do further something. Okay, so there is a site called Pinterest. It's a social media site, Pinterest. What is this? Pinterest.com. This I have not told to this guy. So if you see here, there are many different types of products which you can see here. Like, I mean, it's not that you will get products here when you log in. You have to create an account here, okay? And see different type of ideas from here. You can get ideas, many ideas here. You just say some unique products or trending products, innovative recent trending products. That's what I do. I keep on searching this kind of product. You'll see that product ideas and all.
Okay.
So you'll get a lot of product ideas from here. Take that keyword from there and try to put that keyword in Amazon and see how is that selling number and how the competition numbers and all those things, right? So that would be your.
Yes, sir.
I mean, that's how you can, in fact, get more ideas and words, keywords, right? So you have to get keywords. Okay. And so that's how. Now, let's say one keyword I found, I'll say knee pillow, something is there, orthopedic knee pillow. Maybe I'll say leg pillow instead of leg pillow, I'll say knee pillow now. Knee press is there. Knee something I said. Knee sleeve, knee pillow, knee scooter, knee pad for work, knee brace for home, and knee support, knee sleeve. All those are there now. So you. You try all this, like which one could be knee brace. Let's say, let me try knee brace. I don't know what is that, right? Yeah. Oh, okay. This is the one, knee brace. This is more of like use for orthopedic. This is definitely a competitive market. That's already sellers are. There are many established sellers. You see all those reviews on the first page, really high. So this market, I'm not sure of. If I can again go into sub niche of this market, if I can think of, then yes, I can. I mean, I can. compression something, you'll type compression. I don't know what is that compression. I mean, compression I know, but yeah, compression socks, air, compressed air, compressed sort main. And this is more of like that kind of like product, okay? Injury, space, sports lift, air. Okay, arthritis, something is there, no? What is that? Arthritis globe cream pain relief. Arthritis is a, I mean, is a old age problem. Arthritis globe. Okay, this also would be, I think, competitive because it's a old issue. I mean, it's a old problem. It's problem very. I mean, this problem is a problem which has been there since long time. So that means there must be solution to this problem, right? From long time. So if you find some new problem, and definitely that would be, I mean, there would be less competitors because it's very much new problem. And your product, if you find something to solve this problem, solve the new problem, then that would be good. That's how you can, like, I mean, think of. You have to think of in a, I mean, you have to logically think a lot of things. It is not just that you will just go and find something immediately. It will take time.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
But you see that this doesn't have that much of competition, Arthritis Globe, in terms of the numbers. But the sellers who are already selling, they are really selling good. And they are, in fact, got already good reviews. And for you, if you bring on something, the same type of globe, it might not be good, like in the sense, it would be tough to compete with those already established sellers, right? So if I just click on here, yeah.
Yes, sir, I have one question here.
Yeah.
In this page, a few products are having more reviews. Few products are having less reviews. So can we think like the reviews which are more are more competitive products, something like that?
Reviews like who all are, I mean, whose reviews are more, definitely they are selling, would be mostly selling would be good. It is not that, I mean, they might have got reviews long back, but today if they got some bad reviews, their ranking will drop and their selling will be dropping as well. Okay.
Yes.
So that might happen. Let's say I got 1,000 reviews for my product, but my next lot which I brought in, that lot was bad quality of product. Okay. Then I started getting bad reviews for my product. Okay. Then what will happen? When I started getting the bad reviews, my ranking, my sales will go down. And my ranking will also go down. When the ranking goes down, then ultimately sale number also will go down, right? I'm still shown having good number of having higher number of reviews, but my sales might not be good. But when I'm having good reviews and shown up on the first page, usually my sales would be good. Usually.
Yes.
Because I'm still ranking good, that's why I'm shown up in the first page for that specific keyword, the keyword what I'm trying to search for, right? So right. Here you see this all mostly selling good. This, I mean, yeah, most of them selling good. There are still like sellers who all are not selling good, but they are in still first page. But I would not go for this kind of product because this has really the top five are having really high number of reviews. I mean, three are having high number of reviews here, right? I'll not go for this kind of product.
Okay. Yes,
I look for the product which is below 500. In fact, if it is below 50, that's really good. 100 to 50 if the top sellers are and within that and their selling number is good, then that means market has potential, but this is a pretty much new product, pretty much new market. Okay, that's why there are not reviews, but selling numbers are good. Competing there would be easy. Got it? So when you see the review numbers less and selling number high, that means the product is a kind of new product. But this kind of product would not be a new product. This is pretty much an old product, right? Because as I said, this problem has been there for since long time. This issue is with human arthritis problem is there and since long time. So I cannot think of the product which is a problem of very old problem. If something new which people found that is a issue, you are getting in some product to solve that problem, that's a good market, I can say, right? So this is just to, I mean you are just trying to brainstorm and find different kind of products. So you'll have to keep on doing this kind of thing. So I can say finger, I don't know like what will come with finger. Fingerlings, fingernail, finger splint. I don't know, finger splint, finger puppet, finger splint. Okay. Mm-hmm. But the pricing is not good. But looks to be probably new product because there are not much reviews in the first front page. Finger splint, but the pricing is not that great. You can run Jungle Scout quickly and see that trend. Finger splint. Yeah, trend is really great. Wow. Looking great. Let's see. Yeah. Let's see 1 year trend. Yeah, finger splint. Okay. Trend is good.
More than
trend is good. So you should see finger splint. You got something. The selling number doesn't look good, but I mean, it's not bad actually. See, with 20 reviews, some guy is doing 1,000. 5-7, okay, this seller is doing good. I mean, they have got good reviews, but not much reviews, like much, many sellers have higher number of reviews. This signifies that this product is a kind of new product. This, see this, with 23 reviews, they are doing $4,000.
Yeah.
With 88 reviews, they are doing $5,000, which is good. This is good. I mean, they have, yeah, this is a product you can think of. I mean, you can definitely explore. Trend is good. Then take this keyword. Now you found, right? So you, by doing this all, like this is how you have to go. You can't just think of one way that, okay, I'll have to find a word and work for that. No, you have to do all this here only. Here within this Amazon, you have to do all those things. Keep on doing. So you'll find something.
Yeah. Yes, got it, sir.
Okay, so let's do this finger splints. This is something, a new type of thing, right? Finger splints. Yeah, so you have to see like, how is that? You have to see your parameters. They're all a low potential. Why? Because it's low price. Because, yeah, that's what, low price. Because our price is like, should be somewhere around 12, right? It's all mostly low price, right?
Yes,
it's a low price product. That's why
settings are like from 12 to...
Yeah, so that's what we are looking for, a product which is whose selling price is more than 12. I would say you go for 20, somewhere close to 20, then only you'll get profit. Otherwise, like $12, you may not get that much profit.
Okay.
Go towards 20. Okay, so you see all products are below $12. So that's why it is all low potential product that way. But this one is not low, I mean, $12 below, but still it's showing low because there could be some other reason, because 74 is the review. I set 50 as my review numbers.
Okay,
I have set that because I wanted to find out something which is 50, below 50, right? But if 70 still, you can think of this one, this product, which is getting sold at $12. This is okay. This is fine. You can think of 12.99, but you have to still do more. You can add this as is your one of your product. You can save this and track it. Add to this product as potential product. Then do more research on that by tracking it. Correct?
Yes, sir. Correct.
That is one. You because as I saw, like market is good for this, and competition is not that much at this point. It would be easy to come on the first phase. So yes, you have to think that, like, don't think the selling when you are selling, I mean, finding the product which is, I mean, the numbers are really high. Selling numbers should be high, but it is not that competitions are also high. So competition should be low. That's the kind of product which you will think of. Sometime you will be more attracted sometime, like when you see competition selling numbers are high, you'll think, this product is getting sold high, then I should also bring. Don't think in that direction.
Okay.
Don't think in that direction that, if this product is getting sold high, if I get also, I'll probably get the good selling. But think as well the competition. You have to think competition, how the competition also, you have to do the analysis. If the competition is high, then their reviews and they are already established and they've been selling for quite some time, no point going for that market, right? It'll be tough competing with. So instead, go for product which is pretty new, like this. This is a product which looks like, to me, looks like new because there are not much reviews on the first page itself. But whereas the demand trend is really great. The trend is really great. Now you have to validate this with, let me track it with this one of the product. Go through that process. What is that? Which ones that I wanted to track it? I wanted to track this one, right?
Right, sir.
So let me go back to now dashboard. Now track this product and I'll say finger splint.
Okay.
So this is basically used for finger joint pain, I think. That is the purpose of this product. Finger splint is the is that. Yeah, so it's like it's looking good actually. I mean, the trend is somehow is good.
Yeah, trending is good, sir.
Trending is good.
Yeah.
If I see from 2004, it's been since like 2014, it's been kind of going up and up and up. So it's like steadily going up. So it is good trend.
Okay.
Yeah. So now, I mean, you have to do more analysis on the product side and not only the product, the market specific, like with the keyword and keyword search volume, like those are the things we'll do later. Now you are just validating the market, right? So once you validate the market, then get into more keyword analysis of that specific market. Like how can it be like if that market, if I get some other keyword for that market or not. If you do not have more keyword, just the one keyword or two keywords doesn't make an also you, I mean, it it will be difficult again. Like if it is getting sold today, like with that keyword, if people like changed the, I mean, they are not no more searching for that keyword, and there is, that means that your product doesn't have any, I mean, path for the people to see the product, right? So you should have multiple keywords for your product, like multiple, when I say probably 5 number of keywords as your alternative keywords, right? So keep that in mind, like, but that is something you'll be doing once you have your initial selection done. Okay, so as we know that trend is pretty much good, so it will be showing the same trend, finger splint. Yeah, trend is excellent. Your selling number also you can see here. Monthly search volume. Let's see how is that search volume.
Okay.
This is also good. Like our volume, what we have said, like 15,000 and above, but this is 394,000, which is really good also. And I think I have told also, right, this number what has been shown, it is not the number from Amazon. Okay, yeah, this number overall, is from
overall all search engine.
Overall all search engine number. But to me, like, competitors are not showing up anything, so I don't know if this, there is no competition. Looks pretty, I don't know why there is no competitors here showing up. That means we have to think for this, because this is a product, there is no competitors here, zero competitors. So you have to validate if there is a demand, because demand validation also has to be done. Looks like it's a very new product and there is no competitors, zero competitors. That's really bad. Okay, so I'll see this later. But now, for now, why the competitors are zero? Okay, so there is no competitors, in fact.
Oh, very new product, sir.
Could be, yeah, very, could be very new product. And if there is no competitors, it is little risky in terms of like, going for that market, right? There is no competitors. Yeah. Zero competitors.
Okay.
So
it is risky.
It is risky because that validation is not done yet. I mean, nobody has started. People are in the Jungle Scout, it says, like, you see the number, Jungle Scout or any of this product, right? Sorry, market, this mark, where. Okay, you have to create login here. I don't know if I have, but I don't. I have to see if I have that. I've created viral launch login. Unicorns Master as well. Okay, allow. Yeah, this doesn't require login. Okay. I'll close this. What happened? How do I close this? Come on. Oh, so bad. Okay, I'll refresh the page. So we'll go with that. Okay, so I'll run this Unicorn Smarter, and you see this also here. Also, you'll see something similar kind of result here as well, which says rank your this one as well, your rating, review numbers, and estimated revenues, right?
Yes, sir.
So you see this, and what type of seller is it? It is, is it is ABA seller or Amazon itself selling, or it is, it will be a BM also somewhere? It's all FBA sellers. You understand this term, right? FBA, FBM, and AMZ. Do you understand that, Chandra?
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know what is FBA? Do you know what is FBM? And do you know what is AMZ, right?
FBA, I know, sir, but
okay. FBA is fulfilled by Amazon, which is nothing but like Amazon will be fulfilling your product or fulfilling the seller's product, and FBM is fulfilled by merchant.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that you fulfill your product, the seller fulfills, or the merchant fulfills the product. That means they pack it and ship it, right? AMZ is Amazon itself is the seller. Okay.
AMZ. Okay. Yeah. Got it.
Okay. So here, so this Unicorn Smasher also tells the details about the revenue and all those things. So on the first page, you can see with this $12 reviews, they are making this much. With 23 reviews, they are making this much. But whereas this 454, this they are making $800. So this is pretty new market. We do not know, but okay. So you can probably think of not going. But if you still think of that, I should do more research, then do more research on this product. Okay. So yeah, this is how, like, you will go on finding different ideas.
Sir, I have one question. Do we need to go and give the random keywords like on each category?
Random keywords, and you can get as I said, no ideas. You hear from here, you can get ideas. And this probably would be just the idea. So it is not that you will be like trying to launch this product or something. This requires initial innovation, and if you can find this product in the market. But you have to be careful with this kind of product, because you may not be able to launch the same product. This might be having patent and all those things. You have to be careful with the patent. This kind of products usually might be having patent and all those things. So if you have to verify what type of patent they have.
There are two types
of patent, like utility patent or design patent. So if it is design patent, then it is, the other person, if he wants to innovate by taking the idea from here, then he can design it in different way and make a different product. But probably the purpose is same, but in design way, it is different. But if somebody has a utility pattern, which is nothing but the function, what product does, right? That is the utility. If that utility patent is filed by somebody, then you are solving the same problem in the same way. Then even if you change the design, he can claim that you are, infringing the patent, their patent, right? So that's what you have to be careful. So you can take ideas, or here you'll find, let's say, this product, right? Or it's a 20 or 42 insanely innovative products on Amazon trending. Okay, you click on this, you get some ideas. Take this one idea here. Maybe I'm not sure. You can click on this one. It will take you to the somewhere in the product page or something. Some site, website, yeah. So you can see here like what it is being shown. And magnetic falls. Here you got some idea, right? Some word, you require some keyword, that's all. You don't need the product. You need some keyword now. You're just doing the research on keyword. You're not taking any product or anything at this point. Just taking the, see here, you got something like which says magnetic faults, ILAS. I think this is ILAS more of. Okay.
Okay.
So this is ladies ILAS. And oh my god, this is, see this, the without any review, they are the bestseller. Okay. So, and the product also is in good price range. So within one, and we have to see the number now. Just run Unicorn Smasher. Okay, it doesn't show anything. Okay, it comes, it's coming up. It's coming up. Okay. This seller has good review numbers, but selling number also 6,000 with their review number. But if you see this number 10, right? With the 10 number of reviews, they are making 2,400. It's not bad.
Yes,
in fact,
sir,
without any review, this seller is doing 2,900 without any reviews, in fact. Right? With one review, 2,700.
Wow.
Right? So this is the kind of product what you should look for.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. I
mean, yes,
when I said this means not exactly this, I meant the numbers here, right? The numbers should be low in terms of the reviews and sales. If revenues around like 5,000, 4,000, then it's good. You can consider those kind of, and there are not many sellers on the first page for that keyword, at least that broad keyword at the beginning. Then you go on analyzing the long tail keyword more on when you get into the detailed analysis of each of the product. When you have probably 20 products, then from there, like you drill down maybe like 5 products. Those, for those 5 products, again, you further do more keyword analysis, right?
Yes, sir. Right.
That's what, yeah, that's what you have to keep on doing.
So I need to concentrate on keywords only, first of all.
Yeah, first and of all, you have to concentrate on keywords. And you know that keyword tool Dominators you have purchased.
Yeah, I purchased it actually. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, so that is $49, right? Or how much it was?
Yes, sir. That's it only. $48.
Yeah, so that tool, like you, once you have this, like you can, like when you get into that keyword analysis, right? Then you can do like find out what, let's say if I say what are that finger magnetic faults or magnetic ILAS something, ILAS it was, I think. ILAS swelling is correct. ILAS, that is actually ILAS is, I mean, plural form.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is a ladies product. I mean, if you are comfortable with ladies product, you can. Are like gents, right? Male people will not know much about ladies product, but if you have your sister or somebody who knows about the product,
yeah,
then
okay,
you can take their input and all about the product and all those things, right?
Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
Here you get ILAS, like here on this, you will get more related keywords to this same product, right? You will not
yes,
get
sir.
Random keyword ideas here. You will get related keyword ideas. So
yeah,
that way, like, you know, I mean, when you analyzed five, I mean, when you did the selection of 5 products, then you get more number of keywords for each of the products, right? This tool will help at that point getting those relevant keywords, more relevant keywords, right?
Yes, sir. Right.
So here you, I mean, initially for product and the market research, you have to go random. You can't just think of one way that I'll have to go for this or that. You have to go randomly and look for all sort of things.
Okay. Right? Yes, sir. Yeah, got it.
And what else? Like, I mean,
so I need to maintain all these keywords, like on Excel sheet.
Yeah, just try, means when you are like looking for, no, when you see something trending and good, like one was a finger splint. It was good, definitely. I mean, trend wise, it was good. So what you can do, you can keep that finger splint on your these things, right? Though we could not see that as a very, I mean, good product in terms of the competition. There is no competition at all. So probably it will be much easier when if you bring in this product, much easier to rank in first place. But no guarantee that you may sell it, get sale or not. Yes, buy, because there is no sales record and all those things. There is nothing actually. I mean, there is, I don't know why it doesn't, nothing. So no sales details because there is no competitors itself. So how can it find? It doesn't find anything. So if there is no competitors, there is no details will be shown here. So what the tool which you can use, probably market intelligence or viral launch, market intelligence or this unicorn smasher for that finger splint and do more. Or you find alternative keyword for this and see if there is people are searching with that keyword or something. Okay. Because this keyword doesn't have. So you can find the alternative keyword from here itself, right? Fingers, yes, sports brace. It says sports brace or finger immobilizer, right? This is all alternative words. Okay, finger joint pain. You can say finger. Let's say finger instead of finger splint. We'll say finger support brace. Okay, how do I copy that? Copy. Finger immobilizer brace support brace, finger support brace. Yeah, this is finger support brace, the same product with different keyword, right? Similar product but different keyword. So that again you have to, this is, I mean, this product looks less competitive actually. I mean, still 5,000 search, but review wise it is less competitive. Sale wise, not sure. If you have to see this market intelligence or unicorn smasher. I have little doubt in this terms of sales here. This reviews, okay, estimate, sorry, reviews, okay, reviews are, okay, reviews are less, okay.
Yeah.
You can think of, see, this one is selling 5 reviews with $6,000, right? And their price is $12.99. Good pricing, $6,000. This is the product which in fact, you are tracking, right? So 19.99, and they're selling with 5 reviews, they're selling 6,000 something. That's good selling number actually. So if you enter into this product with good quality, great quality product, the chances are there you'll do good for the longer time, because you are the first in the market in the sense from the quality perspective. And if you are differentiating also, you will also be first in the market, right?
Then, yes, then
it will help you in the longer run, and you will be continuing selling in good numbers. So that advantage you will have if you find something, this kind of product, I mean, this number, I'm saying, okay?
Yes.
So look for this thing, this kind of thing. Don't go for higher competitive products, and which is like, I'll say something like, I'll just take this reverse umbrella. It's a high trending product, probably. I don't know if it is still trending. Inverted umbrella. Or there was a time like when fidget spinner was one. See? It's like, this is spike. Okay?
Yes, sir.
This is spike. You see this spike, like it has come from all of a sudden. Now it is not sure if it will continue long, right? So what may happen, it might be selling really great numbers. If I just put it now, inverted umbrella in Amazon, and just quickly see the numbers. So this is the product, okay? Oh, so many people have got, okay. The selling number would be really high here.
Okay.
One is selling 3,000. Sorry, 3,000. No, not 3,000, what I'm saying. 300, 3,000, the 3 lakh something, okay? Which is this seller with 493. Okay, this guy is selling too much. So if you see this kind of product, stay away from this, because I don't think you should. Though review numbers are, I mean, review numbers are good now. People have got, so this seller has got. So what you have to see, like, I mean, I used to say, right, I mean, 500 should be the review numbers. For first five, if it is below 500, it is good. But now I'm saying not even 500. You look for something below 100 also. This first five. Because okay. We do not want to get into more competitive market. Like, I mean, getting review for us, it will be challenge. Because it initially you will not get reviews. So you have to work in a different way, how somehow you can get reviews. That will be, there are a lot of policies, Amazon policies, which you have to, strictly follow. If you are doing, manipulating, then there are chances that the Amazon may catch us, right? So if you are caught, then they'll remove the reviews and they'll probably warn you and they'll probably suspend your account, right? So you have to be careful getting the reviews at the beginning. So that's something how we are getting. I'll tell that when I'm talking about the review, how to get reviews and all. But keep in mind that getting reviews is difficult. So if your review numbers are, if you're targeting less review numbers which are selling good, if review numbers are below 100 or 50 and still selling this $9,000, $10,000, that means it is a good product. I can think of that kind of product. Okay, but this is pretty much like very competitive market. I'll not go for this, but mostly people will go for this one. They'll say, oh, I'll go for this, right? Because if you are not, if you are going for this kind of product, think of a way where how you can differentiate yourself by some mean you have to differentiate yourself. Are you there, Chandra?
Yes, sir. Actually, I got disconnected just now.
Oh, you got disconnected. I was talking to myself. Okay. So you got it, right? I mean, what I was saying here, when you see this kind of product, this looks pretty attractive in terms of the number, selling numbers. Don't go just with selling numbers. Okay. When you see this market intelligence or the Unicorn Smasher.
Okay.
Here. I'm asking you to use this free tool instead of why to go for buying this Jungle Scout. Jungle Scout also is good tool. But if you're going for this tool, this is also enough for you now. And you see the numbers are really attractive. 1 lakh, this much. Oh, if I sell this product, I'll also make this much of money. 48,000, 58,000, sorry, 66,000, 1,35,000.
Oh,
really high number, right?
Yeah. Looks like attractive. Yeah.
Very attractive, right?
Yes.
So people will think, oh, I should launch this product. But at the same time, you see this review number, right?
Okay.
That is something you have to be. You keep in mind that review number should be less. And even if your selling number, estimate revenue here, most of the sellers, where it gone? Okay. If most of the sellers are like selling on 5,000 to 10,000 range, that's also good number. you can go for that kind of market instead of thinking of this kind of product, right?
Sir, you're telling about reviews, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Like reviews are we should go for not even below 500. You can go for even below 100 like that.
Below 100, yeah, but below 100, yeah. Like that you can go.
So
that would be easier.
Initially, we shouldn't get any reviews. So like that you are
Initially, what will happen, like it will be difficult for us to get reviews, right?
Okay.
So what we have to do, like we have to do very carefully, as per Amazon's policy, you are not supposed to manipulate their review system.
Okay.
What does it mean? What does it mean? Like you are not supposed to buy reviews.
Yes, sir.
Okay. That means you cannot say somebody that, can you please buy my product? I'll give you product free. Or I'll pay you outside through your PayPal account or through your bank account. Okay.
Okay.
I mean, to your PayPal account, I can pay, or to your bank account, I can pay by saying that you can say that, okay, buy my product and give me a review. That's not legally allowed. As per their policy, it is not allowed.
Okay. So
you have to keep that in mind. When you are saying somebody, then that person, whoever is supposed to be, should not be on your social media anyway connected. In any of your social media, should not be connected, right?
Yes, sir.
So you have to find person who is your, I'm not sure, like friends of friends, or if you find unknown person who is not known person, but who is not connected to you on your social media, he has some friends who are in US, then
talk
to your this known person, say that as you are not connected to my Facebook or LinkedIn, do you have any friend who is staying in US? Can you help me? Can you ask them? I'll give them the money to get reviews, initial reviews. That way it will be difficult for Amazon to track if that review was purchased or anything, right?
Okay, so that
is the kind of person you have to find. Don't ever go on any social media, Facebook, and say that buy my product and I'll refund you 100%. Don't say that in social media ever. There are many groups, in fact,
mm-hmm.
social media groups where people do that.
Okay.
So anyway, that's why.
That is not supposed to be done actually
as per Amazon's policy.
Yeah. Okay.
If you are caught, then they'll suspend your account, or they'll remove the reviews, or they'll warn you, saying that you are manipulating the reviews or our review system, right?
Yes.
So that's what you will get. I mean, notification from them. So for that you have to be careful. So you should not do something which is very open. You have to do very closely and which cannot be easily tracked down by Amazon. Their program, there so many people are also working, right? They definitely get into those all things and try to find out. So you have to be very clever doing this, like initial reviews, like initial 5 to 10 reviews if you get, then you can leave off. Then you should not be worried about that much, that you should go behind the reviews. You can eventually, in between, you can like say somebody and get the reviews. One or two. But don't go continuously for reviews. That I'll talk about. Like that's a different session, how you can reviews, what you should do and all for launch strategy and all. Okay.
Yes, okay.
So now you got it, right? Oh, this is how you be doing product research.
Yeah, okay, I got it, sir. Now,
so you can go ahead and then no confusion or any confusion you have.
No confusion. But the only thing is put more hard work to find.
Yeah, it requires time actually. You have to do. I mean, you have to put time. Initially, this product research, you have to put time, really good time. This is the difficult part, product research is the difficult part. Once you find a potential market and the product, then things becomes easier from selling point of view.
And also from the next time.
The selling point of view, and when you are, I mean, you know the way now, selling would be easy. And next time when you go for the same product, it is easy. If you're going for the next, some other product, you know the process, right?
Yes.
And that is, that becomes much easier also.
Okay. Like, I have one question, sir. Like, how do we know that we have covered all the keywords like that? Say, for example, when you take for one category.
Okay.
So, how do we satisfy, like, you know, I mean, I have covered plenty of keywords in this category like that.
Okay, so this is how this tool comes in the picture, right? You'll have to use this keyword tools. There are many tools. This is the one tool.
Okay.
And there is another tool called keyword tool.io.
Okay.
There are many keyword tools, actually. You can use even Google AdWords keyword planner.
Okay.
I'll show you the keyword planner. Keyword planner will be showing more of like, there are many keywords which you'll get, but that keywords might not be all related to product. So it might be a lot of things. So you have to, shortlist or find out the relevant ones for your product, right? So that you can definitely, this keyword planner will get you ideas with the search volume. The search volume probably would not be, not be showing as the number, exact number. Google shows as like 1,000 to 10,000, 10,000 to one, like that it will show. So here, like when you have a keyword planner, then you, for this, but you have to create a Google AdWords account. Okay. So for adding AdWords account, I think they'll be asking certain details in the bank details and all, which probably have to be put in.
Okay.
But that will not charge as long as you do not run any advertisement. This is the Google's advertisement platform. Okay.
Okay.
So you might be seeing, like, whenever you search for anything in Google, right? You see that ad on Google or anywhere, there are like other place. If I say fingerprint, correct?
Yes, sir.
That was one keyword which we want to be ending on. So you see this, get started. You get keywords here, like monthly highly search wall, monthly keywords are here, average monthly search, these are high search risks. You can see, you get some other keyword ideas from here also. Wrist brace, right? So finger, from finger to wrist, you got idea, right? Walgreen fingerprint, sun, Walgreen is a it's a medicine store in US. So thumb splint is there, finger cast. So you get more keywords here, ideas.
Okay.
And relevant keyword also you'll get. So you download this keyword set, you can download this keyword.
Okay.
Your this one. You can say this, and you can, I think you can download this, right? This you can say art to plan, but I think somewhere you can download as well.
It is showing like your account is inactive.
Because I'm not activated ad account. Because I wanted 2 months later has to be paid off again. This is not an account which I run my ad. I run my ad in different account.
Yeah, maybe you can go for more options, sir. Yeah.
Which one?
More options. When you search for keyword.
Here. Yeah, I clicked on that. It says ad as negative, so that's negative keyword.
Okay.
Download would be there somewhere. You can add save. To plan, but add to plan would be select yeah. all.
Yes, save
okay. option. Where? Here it is. Download, right? Here, download keyword ideas. So okay. you select all here, mm-hmm. click on this, then you download keyword ideas. You can download all this.
Okay.
All these will be downloaded.
Yeah. Then go for the one by one.
Yeah, then go for that list. It will be in Excel sheet where it is downloaded or not. Here it is. See, so it has come now. Go for that Excel sheet. It will be in CSV format. You can convert that to Excel format. CSV is okay. is will be opened in fact in Excel only.
Yeah. So okay.
I opened that. Then you do further more research about which are the relevant keyword, which you can keep by seeing the search volume. You see the search volume also here. So it's high. I mean, 100 to 10k, 1k to 10k. Sorry, 100 to 1k, 1k to 10k.
Mm-hmm.
Pinky's finger. So it's up to you how what search volume you are going for, and you can see there. Like I mean, you can mostly go for like 1k to 10k, 10 to 1k may not be. But okay. to get ideas, you can see ideas for ideas. You can definitely see if you get some more ideas here,
yeah.
some other type of product or something like that. But here you'll get more of like relevant keywords again, right? Mm-hmm. Not get random ideas from here. You'll get more related, like instead of thumb, finger, it can be thumb, it can be wrist. It, instead of splint, it can be something related to splint, right? That
yes.
kind of thing you can get. Or some additional like finger cast, CS, CVS, or whatever. Like this, all additional thing you'll get. So that will give you more idea, relevancy of the product. And for your specific product, if there is any relevant keyword or not, that also you have to do research. At least you should have 5 keyword which has high search number of volumes, right?
Yes, sir. Right.
High number of search volume. Search number, high number of search volume, right? So that yes, you have to. Okay, so I think that's what you have to keep on doing, right?
Yes, sir.
I think when I take class, I forget about time.
So yeah.
Okay, so you got idea now, right? So you can continue. Yes, no confusion, no more confusion. Continue on that. Let me know if you still have any confusion, or you can still go over one more time product research. Like if you think that you need, no problem, you can go over that again. With that,
okay,
this is the crucial thing which you should be very confident and.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. Exactly, sir. What you're saying is
right. Yes, you got this keyword file downloaded. You do research. See. This is how you continue.
Yeah, sure, sir. I'll continue this way.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you added any product yet or not on your potential products list?
Actually, I added products and those are not potential. And again, I'm reviewing all these things.
You can go over that one time, like next time when you are. Yeah, so we can go over. I'll just verify that. I'll just check that whether it can be. We can go over and we can see if we'll do basically analysis and see if any of them are potential or not. Right?
Yes,
or
sir.
If that is potential or not, right?
Yeah. Definitely, okay. Sir. From the next time.
Yeah. Okay, then.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. So this guy started, just to tell you, Chalapati. His name is Chalapati.
Oh, he joined, sir?
Yeah, he joined.
Oh, okay.
And I had this Sunday class.
Mm-hmm.
And thanks to you. Thanks for your feedback. So you have given feedback and he said
actually,
that... Yeah.
You're actually completely eligible, sir, but that's no need to thank me.
No, that's okay. I mean, it's all, I mean, when you will be successful, I'll be really happy.
Yeah.
And your success will make me also successful because I made you success.
Yes, sir.
And that way, like, in fact, more and more people can learn from me.
Yes, yes. Right?
That's what I want.
Yeah.
And so this guy started, and tomorrow I'll have session for him. So I'll be having continuous session for him now.
Okay, sir. I just told him, like, you found an absolutely right person. There is no other way that you can find some other guy like this. So there is no only one more test. Yeah.
Okay. And, okay.
He asked about myself and about himself. And I told him, what we can do, what are the benefits that we got. So this is where I just told him, but I think he impressed actually. But he is a Telugu guy.
I know he is a Telugu guy, yeah. He's from Tripur or something, yeah.
Chittur,
no, not Tripur, Chittur. Yeah. You are from that side?
Yeah, I am from that side only, Kadapa district.
Oh, okay, Kadapa.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, Chittur and Kadapa is somewhere near that side only.
Fine. Near the district.
I have to just stop this broadcast.